So, Susanna, I'm struck with this piece, and there are a few reasons why I'm struck with it, because there is an absurd, ambiguous, paradoxical event going on. The analogy, and you have almost like a synthesis and the opposite, what will be of the synthesis, some kind of analysis going on at the same time. But this piece has a strong gravity and wants to break away at the same time. What happened?
What happened was that I was looking at gourds, which are these vegetables, in a meat store where they had been making things out of gourds, and I was so enchanted with the strange shapes. It's so vigorous, this shape. It's really full of this strange life force, and it looks potent. and it looks pregnant, and it looks as though it could make anything pregnant. Mm. And this kind woman gave me a big gourd, and I took it away, and I decided I wanted to reproduce this, and I made a plaster cast, and I began to play with it, and it certainly made me laugh. I thought it was a funny piece. Obviously, there's reasons why one would laugh at this. And I put it in the fire and burnt it to death, and it created all these marvelous colors. And I love the idea that that energy of the fire also helped to produce this object. At the same time, I was working with animal horns and bones and other things, and I immediately thought how wonderful it would be to attach the animal to the vegetable. And again, I'm always, as usual, looking for connections. And for me, this created a tremendously powerful object, almost fetish-like or very primitive, and full of power, and full of humor. So I cast some horns, and I spliced them together in this fashion, and I attached them to this, and then I made something very soft, like the velvet that grows on a horn. I made a velvet stand out of what is essentially lace made from flowers. And so this is a floral arrangement, like a plant. So we have the animal and the vegetable and the mineral. We have heat, we have many suggestions, and this piece, it seems like a live thing to me, absolutely like a live thing. And for me, that energy was very satisfying to have been able to find it and give it a voice in a three-dimensional form.
You can almost expect that it's taking a life on its own.
Absolutely. Yeah. This is what I hope will happen in my pieces. And the name of this exhibition is Skin, Bones, and Soul.
Right.
And many of the images are made from skin and from bones. And we hope that they contain soul, which for me is the poetry of the piece.
This, for example, is
made from an x-ray of my own fingers, which I bashed in a car door in a moment of fatigue and stress from too much work and too many late nights. And when I took the x-rays, of course, I wanted them immediately because I always collect everything that I can that looks interesting. And I began to play with them and put them together in reverse. And lo and behold, a totem appeared in the middle. It's full of figures and animal faces. It's like a totem. And so this amazed me. And I love it when I'm filled with surprises from the things that I play with. Who would have thought that my own body could produce such a thing without my having planned it or known that it could even happen? And then there are many other things here that are shadows of myself that I have seen lying on surfaces and photographed and then taken another step and made into something else.
Here are the spaces
in between which glow and are just as filled with energy as the explosions and the spirals that are contained side by side.
I have one little question that would be like, what is the finest relationship that you find between organic and inorganic? How do you merge this world of organics and non-organics?
I don't see them as separate. I simply don't see them as separate. I see them as connected in the way that air, the air between us is real even though it's invisible.
So air give the life to the inorganic elements?
No, I'm just making a metaphor in the way that you and I are speaking to each other across a space, but it actually isn't empty. It's full, and it's very connected. If we stand close, we can even feel the air from our breath. And this is like a wind, that when we feel the air is when we feel the wind. That is the life force, and that is what I like to feel propelling me between one thing and another.
Right on.